We need to give our young men and women who are out on the front lines, to give them a full spectrum of tools. At one end of the spectrum are things like non-lethal weapons.
From 2011 to 2016, the multinational System Analysis and Studies Research Task Group 94 performed a study to support development and experimentation of NATO and national non-lethal weapons, concepts of operations, employment, and use.
NATO Science and Technology Organization is really people. It's scientists, mathematicians, engineers, technical folks, analysts from across the spectrum of technical disciplines, application areas, and operational capabilities who get together to address specific technical issues. They're organized under a set of panels in a group, one in particular, Systems Analysis and Study Panel, who worked this specific effort on non-lethal weapons technology.
Voting is closed today.
The origin of the project is twofold. You know, first there was a COMISAF study that indicated that with the use of non-lethal weapons that we enhance our ability to hail and warn potential targets out there by 90%. The study also stemmed from the fact that there was a recognition within NATO headquarters and allied nations that there is a lack of integration of these concepts into their national concept of operations, concept of employment, and concept of use.
NATO's policy defines non-lethal weapons as weapons which are explicitly designed and developed to incapacitate or repel personnel with a low probability of fatality or permanent injury, or to disable equipment with minimal undesired damage or impact on the environment.
With the diversity of the study, part of the challenge also had to do with the range of non-lethal technologies that are available. There are acoustic technologies such as a long-range acoustic hailing device or warning munitions that you can project out to hundreds of meters to provide enhanced warning. Other technologies included dazzling lasers, millimeter wave technology to create an intense heating sensation that makes it intolerable for a person to stay in position if you need to move them out of the way or if you need to isolate the hostage taker from the hostages in order to get a clear shot. There are other directed energy systems that can be used for vehicle or vessel stopping if there's an electronic susceptibility of a small vessel or a car approaching a checkpoint, an entry control point.
We started with a significant study looking at the top-down threats in a future security environment. And that looked at a range of issues across a number of factors, including environment, demographics, terrorism, culture, weather, and that generated a selection of scenarios which guided the rest of the study. The study continued with an analysis of the vignettes into which the military could operate a range of non-lethal weapons.
The CDAG, National Military Utility Assessments, NTEX 15M and NTEX 16L each compared actions and outcomes for the baseline, traditional table of equipment, versus with non-lethal weapons also available.
For CESS 94, we organized a concept development and assessment game, or also called CDAG. And it's a game in which we put operational specialists together with technical subject matter experts and have them discuss how these concepts could be used in certain scenarios that we set for them. For instance, a scenario about urban patrolling, and then we gave them concepts that are non-lethal capabilities. I think the game showed us that in the situations that we played, non-lethal weapons can really have a contribution, reducing risk to personnel, reducing risk to collateral damage, those kind of things.
NATO's Defense Against Terrorism program held exercises in 2015 and 2016 evaluating non-lethal weapons in both the maritime and land domains, and SAS-94 provided assessment and analysis support.
Primarily, we had two goals. The first one is to assess the effectiveness and the safety of non-lethal capabilities. The second goal of these military utility assessments is to build trust for the operator to actually want to use these non-lethal capabilities and to actually make a deliberate choice in the scenarios that we have planned to use them in real-life situations.
The SAS-94 group has done the nations a real service in terms of providing us new perspectives for how to use these technologies, new contexts, concepts for their use, identified the impacts that they may have in terms of, okay, so if I use this, what's the effect that I'm likely to get from using that, what impact will it have, how do I best use it, how do I best employ it, what are my tactics for using it, under what conditions, and then tools for actually analyzing those impacts in a way that help us guide future operations.
This work is already benefiting NATO. Allied Command Transformation is using the task group's results in developing a policy and concept for protection of civilians. The NATO Army Armaments Group will benefit from options identified by SAS-94 and DAT-NLC for ways to counter small unmanned aerial systems with non-lethal effectors. SAS-94's work also directly benefits nations, for example, by providing a foundation for new non-lethal weapons multi-service tactics, techniques, and procedures guide.